وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا.
We see that today.
In fact, they had evidence of slipping.
We see that today.
No, it's not a slipping statement.
We see that today.
The next king will answer it.
No, no, I said there's evidence for that.
There's evidence to say that one Pharaoh did this.
And why can't it happen if it happened once?
Because we have, I'm not saying it can't happen, but we have the evidence of one Pharaoh doing it.
But my point exactly, if you can have it altered once, why can't you have it altered more than once? You see what I mean?
Where is
the, this evidence cannot be relied upon because there's evidence like you said once, is altered.
That's like saying, yeah, the Quran can be altered once.
Bring the evidence once.
I can do it. I can write the Quran now.
No, that's not the Quran.
Hold on. I can write the Quran now and alter one little word there.
Yeah.
And say,
you memorize it.
Alter the Quran once means it can be altered.
If that was the only copy,
the logic is it's a fallacious
argument. No, I'll tell you why it's a fallacious argument. That was the only evidence.
Wait. With the Quran, the reason that would work is you would have over 50 million plus correcting you straight away.
Yes. Children as well.
Little kids
would
correct
you. You have hundreds of artifacts in ancient Egypt refuting the fact.
No, but have you got anyone memorized it? But have you got anyone who would memorize
it? It doesn't need to be memorized.
It does, because the Quran has a double...
It doesn't need to be memorized.
It's got a double method of preserving it. One is oral, the other is written. So if anyone like you tries to manipulate the actual text of the Quran, you'll have children as young as 6 years old saying, look, Kalam made a mistake there.
Of the heart.
So we have a double... A way of a double mode of preservation, the oral and the written. Unlike the ancient Egyptians, if you change the hieroglyphics, that is the only evidence, and like you already confirmed, that it's been done once. I'm saying, why can't, if it's done once, why can't it be done?
The whole argument against the Quran with proof 4,000 years ago.
But anyway, this argument is not even about the Quran and about the ancient Egyptians. The question is, how reliable is the text of the ancient Egyptians? That is the question. That is the main question.
The argument is about the miracle within the Quran about the Pharaoh and about the king.
Kalam, your contention.
That's what the conversation was about.
Hold on. No, no, hold on. You said that cannot be right because there was no one called Pharaoh during the time of Moses.
Correct.
This is based on what evidence?
Based upon evidence that you can find written in stone, and based upon archaeology, based upon recordation, that the term Pharaoh only came into existence during a particular dynasty in ancient Egypt.
Okay, which is
and
how
this
long
was
ago?
In 1200 BCE. Okay. This is when it came
and
in.
And what is the evidence? Sorry, how can you verify that?
I'm answering. We have different kings lists that shows you what the names of the pharaohs are called.
How do you know that? That can be verified.
And then we can find
what basis
you
verify
as well. What do you mean? What basis?
How do you know that it's not wrong? Very funny. I'm asking you. How do you know that that is not something that we
have?
Yeah, but how do you know the records are something?
Ramesses the second.
You know, like I'll tell you what. I will write something incorrect now. Are you telling me 12,000 years from today, this incorrect thing can be verified as true?
Okay.
I
give you the logic.
Go on. No, give me the logic of that.
Give
me the logic of what I said.
I would say that personally, yeah. Look at the pyramid, how it was built accurately.
That wasn't my question, bro.
It doesn't matter.
Did you hear what I said? I said if I write something incorrect now, and 12,000 years from today, just because I wrote it now, will they actually say what Hashim wrote 12,000 years ago was an absolute
Is the
extra red record?
Of the pyramid incorrect?
You know?
Is it incorrect?
Your silence of what I said.
No, what's the logic?
Maybe he doesn't want to address it, but you understand.
No,
I'm using your same logic. You're saying, how can the Quran be verified? I'm asking, how can this ancient.
Look at the consistency of that culture.
That is my question.
The question is, you lot state that the word king is used during the time of Joseph, but during the time of Moses, the term Pharaoh is being used.
And you, Lord, say it wasn't.
So you, Lord,
have to verify what you say, okay, based on those records.
You, Lord,
being accurate.
Let me finish. You, Lord, make the distinction to say, look, the Quran knew that during the time of Joseph, it was Malik, but during the time of Pharaoh, it was during the time of Moses, it was Pharaoh. And we have to now look at this in our home. Alright, I like the claim. The claim is nice. The same claim is differently made. But now let's go into the issue and let's see. Is the term Malik ever used in ancient Egypt?
Again,
we can look. We're like, no.
Kalam, the same magic applies.
No, it doesn't exist. Okay, that's number one. Yes. So we know that nowhere in ancient Egypt they were used. No.
The same logic still applies.
One, hold on. That's number one. Then you have the word Faraon.
Remind us to Google a few things, guys.
Which is not in ancient Egypt, but let's just say we use the word Faraa, which is an ancient Egyptian word.
And when that you?
That only came into existence to be referred to as a pharaoh, to a ruler in ancient Egypt, 1200 BCE. Moses, you tell me when did Moses exist? That's number one. And were the person who was a ruler,
actually,
Moses,
you know,
called a pharaoh?
Wait,
it's impossible.
1200 BC, yeah. 1200 before Christ, yeah, you're wrong. Moses could have been Moses.
But everybody claims that Moses existed during 1400 BCE. From the Jews, that's what they claim. From the Muslims down, that's what I'm asking you, because Muslims don't know.
I told you. Because the Quran doesn't tell you.